allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. She did a municipal transfer request, did you see this?
Yeah, but we can't do that, no. Right here, this one, I didn't give you copies because it's too early right now. If you want a copy, I'll give you a copy. We gotta find out.
There's something about the transfer of funds from the accounting clerk account to the account and expense thing, is that the one, is that the same thing?
Yeah.
Okay, fine, then you got it.
I'm gonna give you a copy of it.
All right, that's fine.
I think we might be able to still do it.
Oh, it just came in at 12/19.
Let's see if we have to wait till May 1st.
Well, they wanted us to review it tonight.
Yeah, that's what I'm getting.
So I'm gonna give you guys copies. We got a new member, Tony Auburn. Tony, did you meet everybody?
I think so, yeah.
You met Bill?
Yeah.
Robert?
Bob? Yeah.
Okay, so everybody knows Tony?
He and I work together at Exit.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Okay, you wanna tell us a little bit about your...
Sure.
Specialties, Tony.
I don't know how many specialties I have, but hopefully I can bring a lot. We'll see. I grew up in this town. Worked briefly on the ambulance squad as a first responder when I was younger. Worked on the fire department for a few years. Love this town, it's a great little town, and I think, I grew up, in a town where everybody took care of everybody, and, it's one of the things I love the most about it. Moved away for about 17 years down to Florida. My mom was down there and got sick, and I went down to take care of her and abstained for a while. And met my wife and had some children and moved back here almost 2 years ago now. And would love to find a way to help out as much as I can and give back to the town that gave so much to me. So here I am, back in the town I grew up in, and just want to help do anything I can. Yeah.
Great town.
Great
politics.
Yeah.
David.
Tell us who it is, Bill.
Really?
Truly.
Not even sitting for 3 minutes.
That's right, door down the
road. That's a good comment. Come on. That's not negative at all. Okay, so I'm going to give you guys a copy of this. Bob brought it up. Review it. Marie?
Thank you.
Bob, you get one of those? All right, who doesn't have one down there?
Me.
Everybody down here is. It's up there over there.
Tony, you got one?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Okay.
Everybody's got one now? Two extras here for Steve and Barbara. So let's do the minutes, seeing that we got a pile of them. See if I can decipher what I have to go over with you guys. Has everyone read them?
He's not going to have to vote on them anyway, but he can just look over them. And I think these guys have seen them, but they're probably just refreshing.
Refresh yourself. I'm trying to get caught up on them.
You did a good job. Well, you've been typing your tootsies off, huh?
Maybe, yes.
Establishing precedent, sir.
Oh. The one on October 13th explains our discussion on the catch basin truck, the old truck that we're going to use. They had that last meeting.
You did?
Yeah.
Just saying.
We ended up being right on the money.
Yeah. Oddly enough, I've seen probably 12 solicitations for bids from various towns for catch basin cleaning.
Services? Mm. Where have you seen those?
All over the state.
So your idea of contracting it out.
Well, contracting. We used to do that in the old days here in town.
Right. And what I saw too, it's kind of interesting, is a lot of these smaller towns are forming coalitions, if you will. Probably be about 5 or 6 towns, and they'll put together an RFP and they'll issue it to, you know, statewide, so anybody can bid on it, but it's a more attractive number.
Big mess.
Right, so you've got like 5 or 6 towns in an area, so you get a contractor, a reputable contractor in there to do the work. And I thought it was a nice approach.
The only thing I wonder about having multiple towns is how many, you'd have to look at how much equipment that the company has.
Oh, sure.
You know,
you spell it, it's all
service.
Spelled out.
Yeah.
You have to provide a list of equipment, personnel, resumes, experience,
licensure,
I would say timetables, you know, because if you're doing 5 towns, okay, how many catch basins and how are you tackling such a big job?
These aren't small mom and pop shops that are servicing those contracts. Mm-hmm. These are larger firms, and that's what they do. So. Mm-hmm.
I would assume it's like having a log. You do one town, then you go to the next town.
Exactly.
Right. I would just want to know ahead of time, like, so show me what your plan is here.
So it gives them this town might not want them at this point, but.
Right.
Yeah. They would have to look at previous service records and see what they need.
But we might have to revisit this again.
We might. I'm just putting it out there. It's something that I've noticed.
Well, they haven't got a truck yet, so.
Right.
Right?
Well, the time, the clock is ticking too. So who do we have tonight? We've got
nobody.
Nobody?
We want to do a recap on the discussion on the fire department and the highway.
Okay.
We're missing maybe one thing out of the highway, that CAD form, seeing if they're going to give us a price on the, how much they want to allocate for each guy. That's something we can come up with tonight. I think we should.
Okay.
Because they haven't given me anything, so.
Okay.
I brought this in for you to look at. This is going back to.
And I think the fire department, we're pretty much, what's that?
That's what it was in 05. 6, 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
And you know, there's a question of how they were paying that.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna discuss that too.
Well, because
that's why I wanted to get going.
The CAD form was for the large, any for the over $5,000.
For the gas.
Yeah.
Container.
The welding thing and.
Ventilator and the case for the gas, right?
But then the equipment was another kettle of fish.
That's just
smaller.
That's 3,000, right?
It was 3,000, but
okay.
I don't know for sure what we already supply. You know, what's already included in the expenses that it would be nice to have.
Well, the only sense I got was the vest and
I don't want
some shirts.
And I appreciate that, but I don't...
That's coming out of their money already.
But I don't want a cent. I want, give me what you've been supplying all these years. Helmets, gloves, glasses, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, and let's take it that way, because if it's already in the budget, we shouldn't have to put out extra money for it if it's already in there.
Well, the vest and the gloves and I think the shoes.
Well, we take care of uniforms, but yeah.
And the uniforms are...
Well, there's helmets. See, you know, they wear helmets, but apparently they're due for, or overdue for being replaced.
They have helmets, but I haven't been wearing them on certain jobs.
Well, okay, so that's what brought the whole issue up anyway.
Correct.
But Herb said last week that the helmets are due to be changed. He got notification from somebody that they're supposed to be changed every 2 years.
Right.
And that's fine, whatever, but we need to know all this stuff.
Right.
I mean, thus
so
far...
So we can figure out an allocation per man.
Right.
And then make a separate line item on the budget.
Oh, sure.
Separate, well, no, it's in, it's included in expenses.
Yeah, but she, Carrie wanted to do a separate, for herself, she wanted to do a
separate...
For
equipment?
Yeah, she wanted to do a separate
as opposed to office expenses.
Right.
No, then you can try.
Yeah.
Right, and that will be discussed?
Yoga.
Okay.
It's very much like...
I thought that was a good idea.
It's very much like fire, where they said to outfit somebody costs around $2,200 per person.
Right. I just think we should have concrete forms that say, you know, a hat is this much, a vest is this much, a coat is this much. You
well,
know.
I shared with, I gave him your thing that you got, that you had out, that you printed out, that
yeah.
you did that.
Yeah.
I gave that to him, just as I just as a bouncing
well, bouncing. The thing is, he knows what those things cost already. We don't deal with those expenses every day.
Right.
You may, to some extent, because of the business that you're in. You know, with
not
helmets.
Really. That's operations.
Oh, so they take care of that. But the thing
this is
that,
protective gear.
The thing that
face mask
dawned
helmet.
On me after the meeting. Because when we showed him those and he just seemed to like disregard the company that they came from, which just kind of really struck me as odd. And I thought about it later. That company that these things came from, they supply to National Grid, okay? This is no mom and pop cheap Halloween costume outfit. They supply goods to national firms. So, you know, as far as meeting ANSI, you know, protocols or whatever, I'm sure there were some that, well, no, they would all have to be.
It all depends on the application for the for the gear.
Sure, and there's varying degrees. Sure.
So,
I mean, so that company is a perfectly legitimate place to purchase those things if they chose to do so. I mean,
what's our issue?
He may have another supplier.
We don't have a line item.
Well,
subtotal for all of the equipment.
Yeah, I would like to know exactly what do we supply to them in the way of equipment.
I think it's just coming out of their
comes out of highway expense.
Yes,
right.
Which is fine, but what do we supply?
Because then Carrie wants to put a separate line item for the safety stuff.
That's right. The PPE will get a yearly
allocation,
and then we can give them, and we can probably recommend giving them an allocation per man, how much they should. How they
should well, the thing
right.
is, that's already,
yeah,
it's already in the budget, though,
right.
is
Which
what I'm
is,
saying.
What is in the
All
budget?
That stuff's already been being bought in the budget.
Some of it is.
Except for, okay, not the case for the gasoline or the welding air.
Right. But that's going to be separate anyway.
That's separate, but I'm talking about
Are they getting shoes? Are they buying shoes now?
They buy their own shoes, I believe.
Oh.
Well, we don't know. We don't know.
That's what we need to clarify.
Right, and the question comes up. You got to look at this, that... Since this requirement allegedly now became surfaced, that they're probably going to go back and say, okay, from now on, the town's paying for this.
So it's they want another $3,000 in their budget.
It's going to cost X amount of dollars per
right.
person
sure.
to give them that, which is what
But
you
my want. Theory is it already does cost X amount per person. And are they looking to just start piling on things which they had already piled on? When you're working for a highway department, it's a given. That you need certain kind of shoes. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, and if you're coming to work without those things, then somebody needs to be notified about that and be told, you know, this is that type of work environment, you need X, Y, and Z.
Well, Bob, what'd you say? When you were working the other place, didn't you say they supplied this, and this, and stuff like that?
I bought my own shoes when I was working in a shop. I had to buy my own steel-toed shoes.
Bob, what'd they allocate for you in North Brookfield? Did they give you an allocation per man?
Yeah, it started off at $50, and by the time I left, it was $200.
Yeah. And what did that entail? What did you get for that? I mean,
work shoes.
What else?
That's it.
That's all that came out of that was shoes.
And then the highway was supplied the gloves and all that other stuff, okay.
These glasses.
Right.
You can get safety lenses.
Safety glasses?
Yes.
These glasses cost $135.
Yeah, they're not that expensive.
The prescriptions.
Yes, and that company I had told him about deals in that.
Helmet, ear protection, gloves, any of that?
They had them there.
It depends if you need them.
Use them as you needed them, okay.
But that's what I'm saying, it's already, in the budget though.
But yeah.
Is what I'm saying, there's no need for another $3,000.
That's what I wanted to discuss.
It's already in there.
Good point.
There was only four employees, so they only bought four of everything.
Yeah.
Right, in the same situation down there. There aren't that many employees.
They should have a couple extra.
Down there, yeah, but you know, that's not gonna amount to that much. You have to have the extra in case somebody breaks or, although we have.
No, if they have somebody that comes in and helps snow in a storm or something and they can grab.
This is true, that's true. But we have local suppliers.
Like the tree cutting mask, you would only use when you're running the chainsaw.
Right.
And you only got four guys running the chainsaw all at once.
No.
No, and he said that they have a few pairs of chaps already.
Okay.
Because I thought that would be something they would need, but he said no, they already have them. So.
We only had one pair up there.
Yeah, that's North. This is Brookfield.
No, well, I mean, you're asking me how many, and I'm telling you.
Yeah, no, I'm not criticizing, but I'm just joking.
There's only one guy ran this off.
So what's the bottom line here is that we're not, we want justification on that line item.
We want a realistic figure.
Well, okay. We need to know what do we already supply.
Right.
Versus what?
Sounds like we supply everything.
Pretty much. So, you know.
It's just that they need to be buying some more hot hats and some face shields, maybe.
And you understand that yearly you have to replace vests. They get trashed.
They are
coats
doing
might
that.
Get trashed. Yeah, but that's already in the budget. So
I don't know if he flat out came out and said they buy shoes because that's expensive.
No, he didn't say. He didn't. I think he buys his own, is what I thought he said.
The shoes, when we got shoes, we had to bring in a receipt. So if you only spent $150 for shoes, that's all you got.
Yeah. But there's also should be a limit too, you know.
There should be a cap.
If you spent over $200, you still only got the $200.
Yeah. Yeah. So we kind of need to know.
All right, so we'll get into that. Who wasn't here on the minutes? Everybody here when we did?
It should say right on each one who's here.
We're going to go over five of them, so.
All right.
One, two, three, four, five. I got six. November 21st.
How about September 21st?
That's it.
Which one?
September 21st.
That's the one I'm missing. Oh, no, I got it right here. That's the one I didn't read then. Okay. Good.
By the way, how's Barbara's husband doing?
He's coming home.
I heard he was coming home.
Wednesday.
But I haven't talked to her, so.
He can't talk yet. He's walking good, though. That's pretty good.
Well, that's possible, right?
He's a tough one.
Yeah, but he can't talk, so hopefully.
Take time.
It does. Yeah, but they're going to bring him home Wednesday, hopefully. Let me just buzz through this September 21st, and then then we're going to go down to October 13th.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
November 1st.
Yeah.
November 10th.
No, what about November 28th? I don't have November 10th.
I don't either.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, hold on a second. Wait.
The
15th at the school.
And then the 10th, and then 10th, 13th.
There's no 10th, I have no 10th.
You have no 10th, 13th?
No. I got November 28th.
No, I have October 13th,
you have October
13th. I have 10th, 13th, but I don't, and then
you
I go to
November
28th.
So you need November 1st, 10th, 15th.
You're missing a couple down there?
He's missing three.
No.
Is it November 1st?
Yep, give them that.
Is it November 1st?
Is another November
1st. I've got about three of January 5th. Anybody want to trade?
Well, you can give Tony
one.
We approved that one last week.
You can't vote, but you can see what's been going on and how we do it.
Sure.
Who needs a November one, anybody?
5th? Yeah, please.
Bob, you said you needed one?
Bear with me. You got one unsigned?
I think
we approved those last week.
No, November one I got.
We're all going to sign one packet. I got to move ahead of myself.
September, October, November.
Anybody else need January 5th? Go once.
January 5th?
Yeah, we did that last week.
Oh, okay. I had that right.
All right, who's missing? Anybody else missing anything?
Oh, there's no one.
Is this an original with a signature on?
Yeah, they all are in my pile.
Huh.
What's that?
Mm-hmm.
was I at that meeting? Did I have to initialize them?
This one?
Yeah.
You were there.
Are you on my initial then?
Well, you get one on the 28th. I don't see that one.
Bobby, you got the 28th?
Oh, I got it right here in front of me. Okay, good.
All right. Ready, set.
So you should have six sets. It's the only one I didn't read yet.
I have seven.
I owe these guys five.
Which ones you missing there, Robert?
Six. I only got.
You need a January 5th? January 5th?
We approved January 5th last week, so.
I got more of those than I know what to do with.
We should have six. We should have had six copies.
16.
I have seven.
Might have been one in there from here. Which one what do you got in there? November 5th? That's already been approved.
Oh, nope. What, say that again?
No, November 1st?
No, I got September 21st, October 13th,
yep.
November 1st.
Right.
That's yep. Our, and then?
The 28th.
November 28th.
November 15th, you don't have?
November 15th, no.
A one pager, one from BES cafeteria?
I do not have one of those.
An extra one down there, if I can copy?
November 5th.
Or 15th.
There's no 5th, it's the 10th and the 15th.
The 15th okay. I don't have. I can make a copy.
I don't have the 10th, what are you talking about? 10th of what?
November.
Go ahead, don't make a 10th, I got a whole pile of them.
The 10th, you, that
you
one, yes.
Yeah.
That one, yes.
You have a 10th, yeah. November 10th?
Yeah, I got a whole bunch of them, yeah. Good.
No.
Another one?
10th, I don't have either, if you got an extra.
I need one.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. I appreciate it. Yeah, no problem.
You're going to give it back to me anyway after an issue, right?
Whatever you want, dear.
I thought so. Thank you. One of those guys, yes.
Whatever you want, I'll give it. Right now, what am I looking for? One, two, three, four, five.
Six.
What's that, six?
Not including January 5th.
Oh. Okay, I don't
you should have six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I got six. I got
September 21st.
Yep, got it.
October 13th.
Yeah.
11-1.
Yeah.
11-10.
Yeah.
11-15.
Yeah.
And 11-28.
You got it.
And
got it.
Get an amen.
Amen.
December 12th.
That was last week as
that
well.
That was last week.
Oh, these are all set.
We already did it.
All yep. Done with those, Bill.
But if you want to give them to me, if you want to sign it.
Yes.
Sign one of them and pass it down.
I did.
All right, does anybody have any questions on that?
And that.
On six of them.
Robert.
Thank you.
You don't have to.
And this is the David signed in January 5th.
You don't have to sign that one again. I'm already.
Okay.
It's easy.
Mother of God, I don't need all
this. Might be worth something someday.
Yeah, I think of it that way. Could end up in the Smithsonian or something.
All right, so we're making entertain a motion to accept 9-21, 10-13, 11-1, 11-10, and 11-28.
I will.
So seconded.
Okay. All in favor? Any questions?
Aye.
Should be six of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
What a deal.
Bless you.
God bless you.
Now, you want me, we're going to initial those when we, some
set. Yeah.
We got one set that we're all going to initial, just so we
yeah.
Can
yeah.
Play cards again?
Yeah. Yep. This is December and January.
All right, you want these that I have to get initialed?
Yeah, that's fine. Do you need these for yourself, the 1st, the 5th, and the 12th of December?
No. Okay. I got them in the file cabinet.
All right.
Who's got a set to come pass around?
Bobby, I got them working.
Bobby, you want to sign that?
We're cooking.
Thank you.
I got this set already. I'm moving
yeah,
around.
Yeah, yeah. I heard you.
It's cranking them out. It's like Radar O'Reilly.
Mass?
Radar O'Reilly, wow. Pretty good. I'm dating myself. Okay. That's one of them.
And you sent us copies as attachments, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Love them attachments. Clickety, clickety, click. Send.
That's all I have to
worry. I wish I could be on the other end when you got them. Blowing up your phone.
We checked the door?
I did. I opened it.
Anyone else?
Anyone else?
No, I didn't. I forgot.
He did.
Bob, you check it?
You checked the door, right, Bob? Bobby?
I checked the door.
Yeah, I was with
the thing.
All right, good.
Okay.
Okay.
Good. All right.
That's
right.
Now that you did that, you should really, with now that you're doing the minutes,
well, Marie,
you should probably put that in there.
Right?
I do.
Line
item.
She does.
I do. Yeah.
Marie
put
does.
That in so
yeah.
we don't get.
I asked you to
get,
do that a couple.
We don't get nailed again for that
yeah.
craziness.
All right. Well, that's being passed around, so we can save some time. Did you all see the response we got on the open meeting?
Yeah.
Same more paperwork saying that after 30 days it's going to go
it's,
away and they haven't
right.
acted on it.
Right.
So we in-house did our thing, which is more. That's all that's important, not what goes on in Boston.
Yeah. Right.
As long as we're doing to correct the problem and what we're doing, I'm making sure it's open. Someone else is following up on me. Someone's a witness, and the door's left unlocked, not open. Right, Bill?
It's a fine distinction, isn't it?
Isn't it? Yes. There was a big difference.
Huge.
Huge, he's right.
Come on in.
Come on in, Jeannie.
Yeah. I have a question. If you're having something done in town, like a repair, and what's the amount that it has to go out for bid or whatever? How does that work?
$5,000?
I heard over 5,000.
Yeah. What, is it a service or a product?
It's. We want to have the roof redone on the gazebo because it's in really bad shape.
Yeah.
It's $2,900, the estimate that we got.
So you just get three estimates and you'd be
you
good.
You do have to get three estimates.
Yeah.
Well, you
wait a minute. We've got the procurement law right here.
Yep. What are they putting? Cedar shakes on them? Wood shakes, right?
Yes.
Is that what's
left is there already.
Yeah. How many estimates you get one?
Just the one from the company that actually does it.
Seems high, doesn't it?
They're just replacing the shingles?
Don't you see
well, I think the plywood has to be replaced.
Don't you see if Tantasco, that's a good little project for them.
Good idea.
Huh? $2,900 seems high, God.
Yeah, it kind of does.
8, 16, 24. Well, a man's got to make a living, there, you know. A man's got to make a living.
That's $700 each side of it.
A man's got to make a living. And
yeah.
Include,
yeah, but if they're going to bring it all the way down
and
replace
materials?
The plywood
and
everything
they're
going to
take
else.
It all
oh,
down.
Jesus.
I mean,
that's the whole thing.
Never mind, I shouldn't open my mouth.
Sign them.
Should learn that now, Dave.
Yeah.
You got a bunch of them.
Well, there's nothing for anything
I
up to 5,000.
Right? Yeah.
Anything between 5,000 and 34,999, you do need three bids, but I think it would be a good practice to get three solid bids.
Okay.
But it's not mandatory according to our procurement laws.
Yeah.
So 5,000 to 35,000 should get three bids?
For purchases under $5,000, sound business practices shall be used. The law does not require formal competition for these small purchases. Periodic solicitation of price lists or quotations are recommended to ensure favorable prices.
Okay, now let me ask another question. If we were paying for this out of our cultural council money, do we still have to present this to the selectmen and get their approval?
I would run it by them at least, yeah. Let them know what's going on.
It's a town thing, so it couldn't hurt.
Yeah.
To keep everybody in the loop.
Yeah.
Okay,
we'll establish sound practices.
Yeah, when in doubt, bring it to the selectmen.
Just do it. It's how hard is it to send off a note?
Let them know what's going on.
Yeah.
Somebody's
got
to know what's going on.
They go driving by and the roof's getting ripped off the gazebo, and it's like, hey, what's up with that?
Yep. Did you see the other update from the Board of Selectmen? They want to put more money into line 60, so we're going to change that on our budget.
Yeah.
If you guys want to, that is.
About that.
Well,
now,
it's looks
I
like
did the math on that, and that equates to, and I know that they're saying that if there's extra, if there's money left over, that it would just. I'm assuming go back to free cash.
It does, yes.
Yeah, but you know
but
what?
That's 32 random drug screenings that they're looking to fund with that kind of an increase.
And how often have they randomly drug screened anybody?
Well, I can honestly say that I see those lists come through my office.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't happen very. It happens in the event of a loss, any kind of a loss.
Sure.
If there's an accident,
the hospital,
boom, right
yeah.
away.
Yeah.
No questions asked. If it's a random DOT inspection,
yeah,
I don't want to say how often it would be, but I think that sounds a little excessive to increase that budget by $800. That's just my opinion.
It's $25 per test, right?
Right. So that would be an additional 32 random tests.
And how many?
They were raised by 200.
How many CDs?
From 200 to 1,000.
Thousand.
So they're going to increase it by $800.
It's 800 in that now.
Oh, I'm sorry. My bad.
So they went from they want to go from 800 to $1,000.
Okay.
How much have they spent so far?
They want to increase it by $200.
Oh,
the whole line.
David's got my ledger. So
how much have they spent?
Oh, then I don't have a problem with that.
How much have they spent so far?
But I'll explain to you. I've been through this.
You got pulled over?
No.
Oh.
They never checked more than two of us. Most of the time, it was only one.
How many people do we have in town that have CDLs?
It's four highways there.
Yeah.
Not a full time.
What
checked.
About water department? No?
They're not driving.
Not the new guy.
And plow drivers wouldn't need that then, because that's not a CDL.
Well, it depends on what
they're driving. Well, it
depends on who's got a CDL. I don't know.
Is that the latest one? So they're going to go up $200 on the line item is what they want to do.
Yeah, but the question goes back, what did they spend so far?
It's like,
can we have that?
What's the history?
Bobby should have that.
I just gave my, hopefully, is that the right one, Bob?
Physical exams are $800. They haven't spent a penny.
But it's only, well, they have time to spend a penny.
They haven't spent a penny.
This is for?
That's
not for selectmen physicals, is it?
That, it's under the selectmen.
Yeah.
Right.
But, like, when we did the physical for the new highway guy, it came out of the water department budget.
It came out of water department?
Yeah. And under your highway department budget, you got certifications and that's what they've been taking it out of, too. $930.
Usually they don't use too much out of that.
So what prompted this request?
See, this is not anything new.
That's what I'm saying.
This is not that you being subject to random drug tests is not a new development.
No.
No. It's been out there a long time.
They'll never use it.
What was you had a question?
No, I was agreeing with Bob.
Oh.
You know, it makes it sound a similar model is that now we got a new request because of the Freedom of Information Act. So we don't know how many more requests we're going to get.
Right.
So now you got a bubble.
We're padding it.
A possible. This doesn't seem to be in that type of model. This has been going on all the time. So why all of a sudden they're going to put another $200 at it? They should just leave it the way it is.
You don't need it.
Especially since they haven't spent anything so far.
No, they don't need it.
Yeah. I don't think it's a reasonable request.
Yeah, I know. I know 200 is piddly, but
right.
No, I think you should just hold it the way it is.
It's just falsifying the account again.
Right.
I don't think there's any justification.
So what do you want to do? Do a motion to
someone might
do a motion to reject this request and keep it at $800. Keep it the way it is.
Basically, if there's an accident, there should be
an immediate
drug and alcohol.
And
you're on the side.
And has that happened?
I don't think that happened when he crashed the truck.
When we have had accidents in town?
I don't think that happened when he crashed the truck by the bridge, right?
None of
them. Or the other bridge.
None of them.
Or the on race
none
corner.
Of those accidents.
Well, then maybe they're planning something for the town meeting to have a real splash and they're going to crash something.
Don't even.
Don't go there.
You had trouble getting a report.
Yeah, I did.
All right, let's go back to the motion on the table. We're rejecting their request, and we're leaving it at $800. So, period.
The way we did it already on your budget.
Right.
Okay, so we're going to maintain a motion as to that.
Need a second on it?
I'll make the motion.
Okay.
Who's going to second?
I'll second it.
Any more further discussion on it? Okay. All in favor?
All in favor.
Okay.
So have a nice day.
We got to vote. No.
Yeah.
I'm going to... Tony, we're going to vote you in a minute, but you also got to get sworn in by Michael Sears.
By Mike.
Well, we're going to vote you in a minute.
Sworn in.
We're going to take the vote to vote you in.
Sure.
And believe me, when you get sworn in, that's an out-of-body experience.
Oh,
Mike Sears.
All right, so that's a vote on this one here, and I will put this in your mailbox stating to that effect. Okay? All right. So
all in favor, we did that.
Yeah, everybody's there. It's unanimous. Now let's vote on Tony being a member on our board.
I'll make a motion.
All right, to accept Tony on the board.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Now you get the secret handshake.
After the town meeting, you have to put a request into the selectmen if you want to stay on the board, and then they'll put you on for either 1, 2, or 3 years.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just gotta give them a letter from all that.
So we...
We can put you on until then, and then they got 30 days after the town meeting to put on whoever they want or take off whoever they want, providing somebody's up or somebody's not up.
Gotcha, okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'll put their...
There's room for you either way.
Yeah. Like the new members that... Bill, you didn't get voted in, right? We get voted in by us?
No, it was appointment.
By us?
Yeah.
Okay, so the same thing with you, after the town meeting, you have to put a letter in, and then the selectmen will decide if you're 1 year, 2 year, 3 year.
Can you request how many years you want to do?
Huh?
When you put the letter into the selectmen, can you request, like, I'm looking to be on for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, or they just do what they want?
Well, you can do that, and then they can, you know, say, well, we only have a 2 year open or something.
Right, they kind of, you know, they kind of stag everybody around, so I don't know if they're keeping track of who's coming, who's going, but.
You basically, all you gotta do is go in and ask Karen to be, to stay on the advisory board.
Yeah.
And she'll address it at the selectmen meeting.
Right, but if you want to put a letter in, it doesn't hurt either.
Sure.
So the same with you, Bill, you'll be put in by the selectmen now.
Right.
Because we put you on.
After the town meeting,
right.
That's when
they're gonna change the date for that, I read today, right?
Yeah, they just put that on Facebook, they're gonna change the town meeting.
From Saturday to...
Well, they're not gonna do the morning, because a lot of people called up, so they're not gonna...
They have decided at the next selectmen meeting, I guess.
Yeah. 9:30 in the morning.
That wasn't wise.
Saturday morning at 9:30.
Cheerios and footy pajamas.
No, soccer games, basketball games.
Right.
Going to the dump.
Oh, this is the dump.
We'll hold the meeting at the dump, how about that?
On a side issue with this thing.
The transfer station.
When you talk to them, tell them why it got rejected.
Yeah, I will, yeah. Okay.
Good point.
You know, because just saying no to them, then that doesn't tell them anything.
What's our justification? That hasn't been touched.
Well, we'll stamp a picture of that cat on there.
It's not a new development.
Always says no, you know, that angry cat that always says no.
Grumpy cat.
Grumpy! I should find some grumpy cat stickers and just slap it on there.
I don't have to reply again. Do I do the Board of Selectmen? Because I've got a 3 year appointment?
No, you don't have to. No. Only when you're off, you have to.
Okay.
If you want to get. All right, so let's go back onto the highway. We had a good discussion on that, so we can get that, try to get most of it approved here. Does everybody have a copy from?
I don't.
What is it?
You need some copy.
Which one is it? What are you looking for?
The highway.
Budget, mean?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't think it's...
See who needs one, I got a bunch of them, but I want to make sure we got the right one, because there's two of them floating around.
Yes, please.
Yeah. Yeah, run off for one for me.
We didn't talk about it last week, so...
It's the one with the 2% on it. That's the one we want.
2% in all the anecdotes on the second page. The anecdotes on the second page.
This is the one I want. Yeah. I get the other one. I don't want that one. Who needs copies?
Me, please.
Me, please.
So what's left open for discussion on the highway?
Discussion on the what we're gonna do on the safety.
Right.
Which we haven't got back yet.
And the seasonal?
Seasonal worker, budget. And then we're gonna discuss the secretary too. Because if you notice, on the secretary, she wants more in there. The holidays are already included in her pay, if you pick that up.
Right, that's it. It's in
holidays.
The note.
Huh?
It's in the note at the second page.
Well, but she wants, but she's saying
additional.
Beyond
that.
Plus 9 holidays.
That's correct. Yeah, but that's already built into her budget. But we have a problem here for two. She's going to be short for May and June on her pay. She's over budget by 160 hours. So I don't know.
That happens every year, though.
Not that much.
I think it was when she was doing the thing with the bridge.
160 hours for the bridge?
Was it that, or was it when they had road work, when they did Weber Road? Remember when they had to do that? I don't know, I'm just saying there was a... I know there was a project.
I don't know, I can't answer all the questions, but it just seems...
Well, what I remember from the discussion was that there were a number of grants that needed to be written in that position. And the bridge accounted for a number of hours there. But the problem being that if we then increase that amount, it's going to be carried over, and I don't think we're going to see another bridge.
Yeah, but there's always going to be something coming up.
Yeah. Okay.
So, well, I mean...
Ask me a question.
We got to stay in. If we're gonna, we got to stay in budget here. I mean, that you're talking 2 months out of budget.
Right.
I don't understand it.
What's the position that she's 160 hours in the hole?
Yeah, two months.
Is there other places that we can do a funds transfer?
Check with the other four Brookfields to see how much the secretary gets for hours.
I have not done that. That's on my list.
Are we looking to go step and grade there, or?
No, that's not the issue, it's the hours.
It's just the hours,
just
that's
the
it.
Hours, yeah.
That's another, it's a bad issue, that step and grade, and we need to get to the bottom of that, too.
That whole system is.
Should the employees be doing their own thing?
You mean doing their own step and grade?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I get what you're saying, but I would imagine it has to be based on something. You know what I mean? It has to have been, it hadn't been updated since 2008.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing if you use that as a basis and go from there.
I understand that.
I don't know how to calculate it. I don't even want to, you know, begin to think that
but
I could.
But the valid point you have is there must be some sort of a third party standard, the way you give the points out or something.
They got the employee handbook there also.
Well, step and grade is based on how many years, right?
Yes.
They're making the steps and the grade.
Times and how much per hour. Length and hours. Length and dollars and cents.
I didn't mean to dive down that rabbit hole.
Okay.
Too late, now you got to put on the bad habits.
But Bob's premise is correct. If you're doing step and grade in a corporation, personnel people are not the people that are actually performing the job.
Yeah.
Even though they're part of the corporation, they're taking a different view,
right,
and they're going to call it the way they see it.
Right.
Not the people that are doing the job that so happen to sit on the committee that do the evaluations for that. That's where your conflict of interest is.
Let's go back to this.
We don't want the step and grade is not the issue here. What's the issue is the hours. She's short 160 hours.
Right now, the question I go back to is:
is there enough budget
where they have a surplus in the budget that they haven't used? Because we're always talking about stuff going into free cash. Is there other parts of their budget that would cover those 160 hours if they had to?
Well, you'd have to look at their line items.
The ledger, that's where I'm going with. Is there something sitting there that will cover that? Or are we going to now perpetuate something that's going to now roll over into next year's budget, where all of a sudden now we've got more
concern.
Hours on the book than
we
had before?
That's my concern. I mean, we're at 1,040
hours. We're going to have to do a municipal transfer, and what's going to happen is it can come out of either come out of their budget or someone else has got a budget somewhere else.
That 160 hours?
Right.
If it turns out that way.
Right.
I'm more leaning towards that than actually pumping up this year.
Right. Well, they're only trying to go up a little bit on this year's.
Yeah, but the fact of the matter is it's still an add-on which now gets transferred into the next year.
I mean, 20 hours, I mean, we got a town accountant. She's running the whole show here for 20 hours right now, the whole town. She's a town accountant. So, I mean, there are always going to be problems that they have to deal with. So, I mean, they're going to have to allocate. This is more important than doing that. That can wait. So they can take that hours and work on the Dunbrook Bridge. But 160 hours, that's a lot of hours. Think about that.
But does she have collateral? She has collateral duties besides being a secretary down there, right?
She's doing grant writing, which she does very well on. But see, this position started off at 8 to 10 hours, then it went to 14, then it went to 15, now it's up to 20. And they keep giving her hours, it's for the grant writing. I mean, that's a good part of it. And it's well, and when we do get grants, it's well worth the investment of her doing
well,
this.
Well, the thing is, doesn't the town already have a grant writer?
We have a grant writer as well.
So what's the difference? Why is she writing grants, though, if we have a grant writer? I'm not.
Because she's doing a lot more than the grant writer's doing, too. She knows how to do them.
Right, but...
And she does good at it. But I'm just saying 20 hours, I think, what I'm saying is I think 20 hours is enough for her. But I'm just telling you where, what her, you just asked well, what her role was down there.
Then you bring up a valid point that maybe we should be talking to Carrie to have a separate line item budget for grant writing and a separate line item for this the clerk position or whatever it is down there and let them decide how they're going to allocate the time.
At 20 hours.
Now they're burying it all into one account and you don't,
you don't know what's going
on. You can't download it.
We can't judge how long it takes to write a grant.
No, but what I would like to know is how many hours are they spending and what's our return on investment with their grants?
And how are you, going to know? Well, that's, yeah. When you take her pay by how many hours and compare it to how many thousands of dollars you get back from the state, that's a no-win argument right there because it's going to come out on their end every time. It's you know, it just is. In my
except view. The question I would have, play devil's advocate, yeah. If I'm paying $1,000 for someone to write grants, and they're pulling in $20,000 worth of grants
right.
1 year, and right. I pay the same $1,000 the next year,
yeah.
And all I get is $20,000 in grants, to me, that's diddly. Then why am I spending $1,000?
But the thing is,
because that's what you got to do. They're trying to get a grant on Draper and Hyatt. It may take 3 years to do it. I mean, that doesn't mean you reward that person for it. It just means that they're spending that time and we may get the grant, we may not get it. But if you don't spend that lousy $1,000, we're going to get nothing. But 3 years down the road, we may end up with $500,000 like they did on the Common.
Right. What's this, the third time they did?
This is the third on Draper and High.
Yeah. So she's had to write, but this is the third time a grant has had to be written?
Yeah.
Okay.
But you're applied.
Okay, oh, so you're applying.
Yeah.
So why, if it's already been written twice before, how much effort is it to submit it a third time?
Because they won't take an old one, you have to submit
it. Yeah, it's probably as much effort.
So you can't change the date?
No,
it's as much effort to put it in the third time as it was the first time. Yeah.
But you might change the criteria.
But you got the criteria in front of you already.
Yeah. All right, well that's,
it's not as
the research is there.
Right.
Okay.
Because prices go up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless we're theoretically tracking.
Yes. Yep.
Clerk time. And then when they want to add to clerk, they'll say, "Well, don't put it in the clerk budget. Move it over to grants." Now all of a sudden you're masking what's really going on. You don't have it. You really do not have an idea.
And you
which
won't.
One is because they,
and you won't.
They got about two or three different functions going in and out of the same.
And you will not get what you're looking for.
Right.
The problem that I have with adding a line item for grant writing is that just gets used for what for?
All right.
How do we
all
know?
Right. I agree.
Wait,
I hear you.
How do we know that there was grant writing that was performed under that line item? I think the question is how many hours does this person really need in a year? That's the bottom line. You know, not whether it's grant writing, not whether it's the other responsibilities. How many hours does this person need to fulfill their functions?
All right.
What was the justification for increasing the hours over the number of years?
Well, originally she started to help out the highway superintendent do his paperwork. And that was like 8-10 hours. Then it went to, they just increased it. Then they said, well, we want her to start doing grant writing, and then it boosted up to 20.
See, they're using that.
See, it wasn't supposed to go to 20, because I would see that I met umpteen oons ago, one second, said we do not want it to go to 20. We want to keep it at 18 and 19, but it never did. Now it's 20.
Then right. She got, what, $500 to do the regional thing with the equipment?
Yeah, that's defunct. Yeah.
That was another added $500.
Yeah.
The other thing...
I think 20 hours is a good number, but I mean, but when something like Thunderbrook Bridge comes up, I think that should just be in the 20 hours, and if something else gets slided, so be it.
Well, somebody's down there has got to know how to do paperwork besides her. You know what I'm saying?
That's not the case, though.
But it's, well, this...
They had that other girl, but I guess, I don't know what happened.
No, but even the supervisor should know something of how to do some of the paperwork. He may not know how to do grant writing.
Oh, I'm sure he does.
But,
I don't know.
You know.
I don't know.
I'm sure if you talk to her, she'd tell you what was going on. That's why she's not there no more.
But.
Oh, the other secretary, yeah. The fill-in. Yeah.
I'll be honest with you. I think parlaying into what Bill's saying, we should hold on the hours.
I agree.
Okay. And if they go over, let them, since they probably have paid, there's a high probability they've padded this budget already. And then go back to the expense ledger, and if they go over something, then they use something within their existing budget to cover it.
I've been on board with that for a long
time. And then maybe you get to the point where Carrie is saying, we got so much money that's over budgeted and misallocated.
She already told me that.
And we're thoroughly throwing it into free cash.
She already told me that, Bob.
I know, okay.
So. She's already told me that.
So they need to prioritize us.
All right, so let's do line, all right, it's line 139, correct? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Am I reading that right?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
So we want to keep that at the 17,536? They're requesting 18.
Yeah. I would hold.
What's the
139 is the line.
And what's the definition of the line?
Highway administrative assistant.
Highway office administrative assistant.
Secretary, assistant, administrator. I think it's, what she does, as far as the grants go, she does very well at that.
Oh no, I don't want to see this
position keep getting.
You get mission creep. That's what you're getting.
That's what's happening.
Basically, what's going on.
Yeah.
And what's the current? What are they requesting?
18,473.
But see, we do these budgets, and it just 160 hours. You guys said she had to do the Dunbrook Bridge. You think about 160 hours. That's a lot of hours.
That's 2 full months.
It's correct.
But what she didn't tell you...
At
20 hours a week.
Right.
What she didn't tell you is she was actually down at the bridge with tools repairing the bridge. That's where she was.
I didn't see her down
there. So they're requesting 18,473.
As long as she had a hot hat on.
That's right.
Then she's okay.
And protective gear. That's it.
If they needed her down, she'd help them out.
All right, no, seriously, let's go back and stay. Keep them at 17, level funded.
17,536.
Right.
Someone want to entertain a motion to that?
The advisory recommends level funding of line item 139.
Correct.
Okay.
And what's the amount for the level funding?
17,536.
Oh, that's not level funding.
That's line 139.
Yeah, it is. It is, Bill. Don't even go across.
Just go across from 17 to 18.
FY 17, it is.
17,536.
Just go across what you had on 17.
I got it.
Yeah.
I got
see
it.
Yep. 17,536.
Yeah.
Yep. Tony, we're going to keep the, just so you're gone, we're going to keep the line 139
to what they had in 17.
Oh, I thought we already voted that.
We took the budget under advisement.
We did.
Okay. Wait a minute. This doesn't add up.
We're not going to change it. In other words, we already voted it.
We did not vote.
We kept it under advisement.
We took this under advisement.
We needed it more information.
What's the matter, William? No.
There's a discrepancy here in the numbers. We've got 17,536 for FY17, and we're going to level fund that to 17,536 for 18. But in the...
You're looking on the back page?
Right, on the note, it says current rate is 17,368. Right, 17,347.20.
Oh, so that's...
Plus 9 holidays. So 9 holidays
But the 9 holidays are included.
Right.
Into the figure. Get me?
Yeah.
So it's not a plus then?
Huh?
So it's not a plus then?
Well.
No, it isn't. Not now. It shouldn't be.
Well, it's going to be additional.
It should say includes 9 holidays.
Right.
Right.
But she's saying...
My confusion is in the discrepancy between the two numbers. We've got 17,347.20.
Well, get the calculator out then and see,
Yeah, we'll just do the hourly rate and then 1,040 hours. That does equal 17,347.20, I'll bet.
So you want to multiply out?
16.68 times 1040.
I think we should just keep the level funding myself.
16.68 is the hourly wage?
347.20?
Yes,
16.68.
Yeah. And that includes
times
the holidays.
1,020.
Yeah. Is that Bill?
That includes 17,347 is 16.68 per hour times 1,040 hours.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's the difference.
But I'm saying we have just
188.
It's not going to be a big to-do either way. I would just say keep it the way FY17 is.
Yeah, level funded, 17,536. Right. It's just that I think
you're
there's a math
$200.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, but if you divide that up over X
okay. Take that. So we voted that in, correct?
No, because he discovered the.
So all right, so we want to make a remotion to entertain the 17,536 for line 139.
Who's making the motion?
Someone
to entertain. I am.
Okay. And who's going to second it? Unless we got some more discussion.
I'll second it. I'm good.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
See what it says here. Plus holiday.
We discussed that. Yeah.
Including.
Which is, it already should be included, though, right?
I wonder if you should ask about that.
She said that. She said she wanted more. With, she said plus the holidays.
Well, that's more money.
Yeah, I know that, but she did state that.
But they're already gets paid for holidays.
That. They're already built into her per
right.
week.
There's your mission creep going on right now.
Yeah, I already know that, so. All right, any more discussion on it? We good with it? Or?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's jump over to see, how about let's discuss the seasonal worker that seemed to be.
What number is that?
That's 1385, oh. Line 1385, right. Front page.
And it was figured out, you can only do it for 6 months.
Yeah, it was 13,520.
That's right, the bylaws state that you can't go beyond six months.
So it was 13,520,
right.
Is the number that's in there.
So how much time does it have to be after 6 months before they can rehire the same person?
That's not clear in the law.
6 months, I would think 6 months per fiscal year.
Oh, okay. It is per fiscal year, right?
Yeah.
But then you could probably, for a different season, you could take on another 6 months, but you're not going to get more than 6 months out of
total.
Each fiscal year.
Right. So what do we want to go from April to November, or do we want to just
I thought
May would be better.
I thought they were going to choose.
Yeah, exactly. I don't believe that we wanted to tell them their business and when that would be.
So we want to give them 6 months.
6 months is what they have.
As according to the
right, and then and then the rate, right, per the bylaws.
But see what happened last year. I'll tell you what happened last year. A guy quit, and they couldn't find anybody for 6 weeks. So that means that money was sitting in there. That money should have been going each week, when it wasn't. So what happened when they did find somebody? They just kept this guy sailing through to January 15th, thereabouts.
Meanwhile.
But that's not the purpose of a seasonal worker, to be fixing lawnmowers.
But meanwhile, yes. That work was getting done while those 6 weeks had nobody in
that's
that
correct.
Position.
That's correct.
So what does that tell you?
Well, I know it. I know.
It, you
I
know what I mean?
That.
The guy was missing, but yet the work was done.
That money should have went back to free cash.
Yeah.
Well, then did use.
But once again, no one was watching, so they were just, I mean, what do you get? You get four guys in the highway barn in the wintertime. What are they all doing? I mean, it might be cheaper just to send the lawnmowers out and get them repaired.
Charlie's right down the road. You don't have
rather
to
than far. Have somebody in there for weeks on end doing a few lawnmowers.
I don't want to tell them their business. Well, I think
I guess what I'm trying to say to you guys is you the seasonal worker is to be doing outdoor work, is guess what I'm trying to say.
Right. Appropriate to the job description, which right. I don't think we have a lot of clarity on. So we know it's 6 months, and I think what we decided on when we last talked was going to be $13,520
right.
for that 6 month period. Mm-hmm. And so that works out to be about just over $14 an hour if you've got 6 months, 24 weeks. But then, you know, some months are 5 week months and whatever. Mm-hmm. So I think we figured out over 6 months, over that many pay periods, it'd be around $14.
Okay, so you're figuring 14 because they have a guy right now for 13.
I know.
They complained that they couldn't find him, but they got a guy for 13.
They were looking for 15. I think if we say that they've got a budget of 13,520, however they want to split it up over 6 months, I think that's reasonable.
So what happens if they don't start this guy till, let's say, the end of May? We're going to have somebody working in the highway barn in the wintertime again. Doing what?
No, May is the fifth month.
So it was made in November.
The money that's left in that account right now is gonna last till June 30th.
And how much is in there now?
There's about 700, right, Bob?
You'd only go to the end. You'd only go to the end of October if you started in May.
Okay, but we're not.
Depends when.
This is the Y18 budget, so it's going to start July 1st.
Right. So say it starts July 1st.
So July, August, September, October, November.
$7,700.
December, January, because if you don't start May 1st, you'll be in January again. And the seasonal workers will be doing seasonal work.
Right, but why couldn't he stop when the seasonal work stops?
Start back up
in the spring.
To be honest with you, I don't really care.
Okay.
Yeah. They're doing.
Because when we come back, okay, well, let's do that. Okay, either way, it's going to come out.
Right. It's
going to work out good for them, right? 6 months.
6 months.
Okay. I think we hold the bylaw 6 months.
That's it.
Okay.
And if they use it up in the winter with the guy fixing lawnmowers, then are they going to mow the lawns in the spring, I guess?
But there needs to be some accountability for that spot, too. Yeah. That budget is going to, because there's still a lot left in that budget right now. So they need to be drawing off of that budget for the seasonal employee and not sort of paying it forward so they're here until.
Well, when I found out someone was down there for December and January, what they said was there's money in the budget. What's the problem?
There's like $8,000 in
right.
there.
I think he just said, so Bobby, how much money's in that thing?
About seven, right, Bob?
Bob, how much money?
In the seasonal, $7,790.
So that's gonna
almost $8,000.
Oh,
out of 14,000, that's they've used up less than half.
They had 14,560 to begin.
They had 14,560.
That's where I have a problem, is they used less than half of that budget. This
right.
person
but
has been on the payroll.
46%.
Yeah. For how long? Since what, May of last
May, I think last
when did he start? In May? Yeah. You said we were out without somebody for 6 weeks.
I think it was around then.
Maybe, how has that person been getting paid? You know, out of what budget has that person been getting paid? If they're not a seasonal employee?
Right.
Well, I think what was going on too was I think when this guy was on it for December and January.
He's doing snow and ice, I know.
It went under the snow and ice account. Yeah. But my theory was this guy was hired to do cut lawns. He was to help cut lawns.
Right.
And paint walks and help the highway get things done while the weather was good.
Sure.
But that now it's getting, then it went into the wintertime. Well, we fix some lawnmowers now, you know?
Don't you do what Bill's suggesting.
I'm on board with that.
Give him 6 months. Here's your budget.
Right. That's going to come in. That's going to come
nice,
on the other
have
side.
Have a nice
bylaw.
And have a nice
day. The only thing is, if this, like what's happened, what seems like may have happened now, is you get all this money left, that person has been working, and it's coming out of snow and ice. And snow and ice is the only account that you can deficit spend. So hired for this account, then that's where it should come out of. It shouldn't be pushed over to snow and ice.
Well then it's that department's responsibility.
Coming out of snow and ice is because that's what he's doing. He's plowing.
Right.
They told me he was plowing.
But that's not what that person was hired for.
Right.
That goes back to what I said. He's a seasonal worker to help get things looking good in the town.
Right. And if you've got a job description, fine. What you do within that 6 months period, so long as it falls within that job description, that's going to come out of the seasonal worker budget. If they want to hire him for snow and ice, well, that's a different.
So even if he works, 20 hours a week, it's still going to be 6 months.
Right.
Because you're not looking, as long as he stays under that description.
Right. Okay.
Now what if he's.
Are we going to keep it, are we going to recommend 14 or are we going to keep him at 13? Because you guys are basically, we're giving
him
a
dollar.
Yeah,
but is it 13 even or is it 13 and change?
13,520.
What was it?
13,520.
Yeah.
All right, here's the thing. We're already into April. And it's still $7,700 left.
I was gonna say, what's going to happen with that money?
Goes back into the kitty. And that's the problem, Tony.
That's
we have
over
all this free cash. That's why we're trying to
well,
do
that
here.
Well, that $7,000 will cover her 160 hours that she's not funded. That's the whole strategy. That's the reason why I said hold on.
What is, divide 1668 into 7,700.
The other thing, by bringing him in to a different
Please.
Job.
What number am I doing?
He could go over and go.
$7,700
That's why the bylaw was set up that way.
16.68
Right. You can't have them go beyond 6 months.
461.63 hours.
For that reason.
That's 461. And she's only 160, so that's still 300 hours worth of money. Even if you took it out of that.
How's that look? How much? You get enough to pay
her? If you paid her at her rate for 160 hours.
Yeah, she's gonna be short.
Right, that still leaves 300 hours worth of pay on the seasonal account.
Yeah. Bob, what's in the assistant account right now? What's left in the assistant account?
16.68
Yeah, how much is left in that ledger?
Say again.
16.68
I'm just. She said she's gonna be short 2 months. I just want to see
times 160.
If that's pretty close. She wasn't being real firm, but she was pretty.
$4,217
Thank you.
Okay.
That's at the end. End of.
That's how much is needed. 316.
For the 60 hours.
To cover
60
her.
Over that she's over.
To cover her.
That's the middle of March. 316.
What do you tell? What's 316?
That's what this ledger is.
There's $360.
It's up to 316. March 16th.
Oh, the ledger. Okay. As of 3/16. What, in that account you're talking about? How much is left?
The highway part-time office clerk.
How much is in there?
She's taken out $13,318.98.
But what's left?
And she's got left $4,217.02.
I think she's gonna have enough.
She's taken out 76% so far.
We got 3 months left, right?
You wanna divide 1668 into 42?
What am I doing again?
Oh, do 340 times 12, just roughly.
Give me a number, what is it again?
340 times 12. What is that?
4,080.
We're gonna be close.
There you go.
We're gonna be close. So I don't know what she was. I don't think she's gonna be over then. There's no way she could have been over that much.
Don't even worry about her being over. We got it's covered.
It's covered. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to figure out. But it's good to see if she was or not. So I don't think she was. Okay.
Can we go back to line 1385?
Yep, sure.
I would recommend we leave it level funded at $14,560. That gives them $14 an hour at over 26 weeks, 40 hours per week. That's a 6 month period.
We already went $13,520. So
right.
What did I come up to?
What's that? Well, it's
voted $13,520.
Right. I just did the numbers and it's 26 weeks.
You gotta remember that other guy, the lowest guy down, is getting what, $17? You can't. And he's got all the licenses.
I got it. So if we're paying this person $14 an hour, okay, which is what this would work out to be, at $14 an hour times 40 hours a week times 26 weeks, which is 6 months, it's $14,540
hours is what 6 months should be.
Okay, let's do it. So exactly, 1,040 hours times 14 is 14,560. So I think we had our math wrong at the 13,520. I think
we're going with $14.
We're gonna leave it at 13?
Yeah. Because the other guy's getting 17 with all the
all the licenses?
Remember?
Well, my argument
was up to this. I don't think it's up. I mean, yeah, we can make that recommendation, but I don't know if we should.
Exactly, and that's what they're paying them now. And my argument is that for $13 an hour, you're not going to get.
They got somebody though.
Okay. Well, if they've got somebody for $13 an hour and they want to maintain that, then $13,520 it is.
Well, I mean, if they want to, you know, I'm not gonna balk it or fight it if the guy wants to get $14. I'm not gonna fight.
I wouldn't. Guy. Yeah.
I have a question. Obviously, Brandon is. So I don't know. Why
What's your name again?
Tony.
Oh, Tony. Okay, go ahead, Tony.
Why take a seasonal worker at 40 hours a week for 6 months and run into, you know, when you're going to use them, when you're not? Why wouldn't you just take that and turn that into a part-timer money at 20 hours a week for the entire year?
Because then it's benefited.
Then it benefits.
Okay, thank you. That's what it is.
It's cost the town.
The original thing, the way this started, was only for grass. Okay. Now, then they kept throwing this other stuff in there. I tried to get more.
Well, if it's only for grass and if it's in there.
Benefits add significantly.
No, I know that about the fixing the lawn was that rate.
All right, so we're going to leave it at 13,520.
Yeah, and let them take it from there what they want to do.
That's the budget. Within 6 months, they have 13,520 for a seasonal worker.
And if they, okay.
I'm good.
So, okay.
So we never, we didn't do a motion on that.
No, we didn't. Well, we did the last time we met. We left it at 13,520.
No, we didn't even vote on this. We took this whole thing under advisement. We didn't do any voting on this.
We didn't?
We wanted more information.
I remember that night we were just taking data, because they were here to what, 9:15?
So can we vote on this the way it is now, without knowing the information about the personal protective equipment?
Well, we just pretty much said it was already pretty much in there.
But
we're gonna add the gas chest and the ventilator.
Right, but not the other $3,000.
But the other $3,000, we're just gonna say that's in there.
It's already included in the budget.
Right, unless you guys want to put $1,000 in for helmets and whatever, extra stuff. That's up to you guys. I think they got enough in the budget to pull.
But I still feel uncomfortable. I don't know if it's policy that they're buying the shoes or not. Are they buying shoes?
Well, they've been wearing something all this time.
That doesn't mean anything.
No, I know, but somebody's been buying it. That's what I'm saying.
And it could be the employee. That's what I'm saying.
And if it has been, and they've accepted that as past practice, why is that a bad thing?
No, it's a town policy. Do we have to provide the shoes?
Right.
Oh, I wouldn't think so.
Well, isn't that what they're talking about?
If it's a safety requirement, I don't know.
But that's a given as part of your job in that department. You know what I mean? If they've accepted that as a safety requirement all these years, and everybody's been doing it, you know what I'm saying? You're not gonna show up to a job you know that you're gonna get hurt on without the proper equipment, even if the town requires, or whoever your employer is. If they say, I'm sorry, I'm not paying for your shoes, if you want this job, you gotta buy your shoes, then you buy the shoes. So I'm just saying, what is the practice now?
All right, go back a second.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Well, what is the practice?
What's the requirement for fire department?
We provide all their equipment.
What's the requirement for the police department?
Part-timers supply their own.
Okay, so that's
full-timers
one.
Get an
sidearms, everything. Yeah,
that's correct.
Yeah.
The what? Say again?
The whole line, sidearms and everything. If you're a part-time
officer. In this town.
Okay. Right. Well, who's figuring this out right now? Is that the personnel board? Who's figuring out? Isn't somebody
figuring out what?
About the equipment and the safety requirements and all this other stuff. Who's dealing with that right now?
Well, they're going to write up a policy and a procedure book. But
who's writing
with on the selectmen?
Selectmen.
But we're just trying to allocate. Do we need more money in their budget?
Right, and that's why I want us to be what Bill's alluding to, have a consistent policy across the thing. So if certain equipment is required for highway, certain equipment's required for fire and police, I would assume it's going to be consistent across the town.
Mm, equal treatment.
It's straight across and not different for each for each department.
What's North do? They supply shoes? What's the normal practice in other?
Well, he said the North that they
give you.
You have to go get your own shoe, but you get reimbursed for it up to $200.
Right. Well, buy your own up to $200.
We didn't ask. Shame on us. We didn't ask that question when they were sitting here.
And I think what type of shoe it had to be, right?
It's got to meet the safety standards.
They know, but they know what's required. You know what
I mean? I'm not assuming anything.
Right.
Well, I'm just saying, they give you a sheet. Here's five different types of shoes that have the safety thing that you're doing. You can go buy them yourself, and you will be reimbursed up to $200. That's the policy.
Well, turn in a receipt.
And turn a receipt. That's
and
the policy.
They have to meet the certain
right.
Thing,
and these are the suggested things: steel toe and certain shank and everything.
Not suggested. Required.
One pair of boots for the entire year. Huh? One pair of boots for the whole year.
Yeah, well, it's not like firewood. It's not like
yeah. You can get a couple pairs of two pairs of $100 shoes if you want.
If you bought them for $100 a pair, you could buy two pairs. Yeah.
Okay.
The fire department can be different because they're running and doing brush fries and they could melt their shoes off or something. Mm-hmm. So that's a little different. But
we don't give our guys anything towards their safety shoes. And some of those shoes are like $300-$400 if they're working on lines.
You can go.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean lineman boots are for your department?
Gaby Tree.
Lineman boots can be $400. You know,
yep.
And they don't give them, we give a discount like we have deals with other vendors like Red Wing Shoes.
15% off, 20% off or something?
10 maybe.
Well, I'm going by.
You guys are generous.
Because Cracker Barrel gets coupons from Payless for skin slip resistant shoes for 15% off.
Right.
But you know, those are
ballet. You guys, that's ballet slippers, right?
I think
slip resistant. You ever ran through a wet kitchen?
I think there should be equal treatment, though. If we're providing for police and fire, then I think highway department, if it's required safety equipment, mm-hmm. there should be an allowance, an annual allowance. But I don't think we know what
I'll
that
ask
is.
That question.
For things beyond.
I'll ask that question.
Only for things beyond what is already included in the budget. Because like I said before, some of this stuff is already in their expense account. We're already paying for all those things.
Do we know what that is?
That's what we
need. That's what I was going to ask. Like,
Well, the vest, they're paying for the vest.
We pay for uniforms. For the shows.
We buy a new vest every year.
They get more than...
They get more than because I talked to Herb after the meeting. They get ripped and
they get thrown away. T-shirts and
it's in there.
Before you bounce their budget up, I would recommend that we find out definitely from Herb what the hell the damn thing is. I mean,
what's included in the budget now
and what they're going to need. Then we start from that. And that flame resistant storage tank and the acetylene thing is a separate issue.
I think this is what I would recommend, that we go by what's on this budget. I'll find out what he is not paying for, and we have to come back and adjust this. And we'll do we'll do the gas chest and the ventilator as an article. And we'll take it out of free cash.
Yeah.
What do you think of that idea?
That's nice.
And then if we can approve this, and then if Herb says, well, we're not buying our guy's shoes, then we can come back and put a little bit into this.
Sure.
Okay, we can just amend this. We can just come back and do a quick recap.
That's fine.
Okay. What do you think of that idea?
That's good.
Here's the thing. When you ask for that information, I would ask for supporting documentation. Yeah. Where are the bills from the companies? Wait, from your supplier.
Then they're going to tell me that I'm micromanaging.
No, you can get that from Kerry. You could probably get that from Kerry.
If you're going for change, then you can approve the budget.
Right. What have they spent in the last 3 years, each fiscal year, on safety equipment?
So what would you ask, Kerry?
Yeah.
Well, she'd have to go.
I'd go back.
I'm going to ask Cindy at the highway. I'm just going to go back.
I'll say because the question of...
Cutting trees
with no helmets on.
No helmets. That's what's happening.
And I don't understand how that happened. I don't understand why that happened.
Well, if we only outsourced it, we wouldn't have to pay for it.
Why would somebody be cutting trees without helmets on?
Of course, we already bought $25,000, $30,000.
I'm the one that brought it up at the selectmen's meeting. I wasn't trying to cause a ruckus. I just was out there watching them when I drove by, and I saw a piece bounce off the road and almost took the guy.
That's not cool.
I wasn't trying to cause a ruckus, but
no, we got to deal with it.
Well, which is good. It's all good.
I think we'd have a worse ruckus if somebody got hurt or killed, and then the town was liable because of it.
That's a problem.
Yeah.
I mean, it's all good all the way around.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like your idea. Do your idea.
So, what else we want to? Go through in this budget? Anything else we need to scrutinize or? Seasonal work.
Now the only thing is, it's on this page here. It says that 140. I'm assuming I'm looking at the right line.
Flaggers.
It says it was 3,500 level funded, and now it's now got changed.
Well, it was 1750. That's right.
Now why did we do that?
Project.
Okay. I'll explain that again.
Because
project. Listen, Bob. Yeah.
So it's 3,500 in it. They've only used $704.
Okay.
That's why we cut it.
Okay, fine. Okay,
okay,
that's it.
There was 3,500.
So they've over budgeted for that. I don't know how much.
Way over budgeted.
So what are you recommending?
1750
is what we
recommend.
Cut it to
17.
Yeah. 50. $1,750. Oh, I see. It's right above.
Yeah.
We already did it.
Okay, just so we make sure we got the right. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, Bob.
We got to stop the over budgeting. You know?
Well, to be honest with you, all the money that we just saved just now will cover the 160 hours that are not budgeted.
But now looking at that ledger and doing the math, right? I don't. She said she was short 2 months, but I don't think she is.
Yeah.
That's an account that was only $500 back before.
I think she's going to be all right, Bob. All right, so that's, all right, what other questions? So that,
I'll be honest with you, I've seen places where they have the flaggers.
Okay.
And it's it's an automatic mannequin that they set up with a hat and old thing like that, and the thing goes like this on the back. And I am not pulling your chain. It's a mannequin that they just set up on a site, and it actually, it's a flagman and then everything else like that. It's not a person.
What does it have, a remote?
It has a remote on it with just the arm moving with the flag.
It doesn't stop one side and go the other one. It's just a warning. I've seen it.
Yeah. Thank you very much. See, they think I'm making this stuff.
Yeah.
That doesn't sound too safe to me.
I think you've been drinking bilge water or something.
All right, let's discuss the snow and ice account. Carrie, the accountant, suggested that we bring that up, $5,000.
Yes.
I'm not on board with it myself. What do you guys all think?
No.
No. I don't think it's a good idea.
That affects the cherry sheet.
Yeah.
No.
All right, so we're going to keep that there.
Except we have to go at least on record that the reason she's made that recommendation is because she thought of incrementally bringing up because it has been traditionally underfunded.
All towns are.
Okay, fine. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, I understand what you're saying, but
there was. But you can't go backwards. That's what our point is. Yeah. If we go
the state won't let you.
Right.
Then you got to stay at that
can't
number.
Can't reduce it.
Okay. All right. That's cool. All right.
We brought that up, and we only did it once. That was the other board that did it.
Now, is that what the over budget is right now? Is 132 on the snow and ice as of before this last storm?
That's what I'm saying.
You need another storm. It's way over now.
Okay.
Yeah.
It ain't done yet.
They haven't come back for us for. Oh, they don't have to.
We don't know more. No. So you ain't gonna know.
But state, they passed that. They used to come here and tell us they're over budget, so we could see what's going on. But now the state passed that new law. They don't have to do that.
Well, we can tell from the ledger.
That's correct.
We can tell from looking at what's over.
But it just doesn't give us a heads up.
The only thing I think we should have is that if we're recommending that the 75 stay the way it is.
Yeah.
That we at least have something in the minutes to reflect why we're not increasing it. That's all.
Yeah, just
what you just said. With the cherry sheet, you can't go back. Blah 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 blah. Just so people reading it, they know why we're doing what we're not being crazy. There's a reason why we're doing.
I'm gonna get my angry cat stickers.
Hey, I got it. The highway does pretty good when they get down to that flag. They try to do it. You know, if they can do it themselves, if they can shut down a little road.
Yeah.
Or they can pull a cop off his.
See
cruiser for an hour or two or something.
What it was years ago?
What was it?
500. What year was it? 2009 was 500.
500
for snow and ice?
$500 for the flagger.
Oh, for the flagger.
Police detail flagger.
Yeah.
All right, so let's leave it at the 1750. With the snow and ice, we'll leave it at 75, right?
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
What else? You know, we get to discuss the tree, shade trees too.
Yeah, we haven't seen that budget, have we?
You're gonna leave the highway expense at 60, right?
Well, yeah, we've got 16,000 in there still, right? Or we had that, it's probably less than that.
What line you want?
141.
What line was snow and ice?
All the way to the back.
153.
So at 60,600 for 17.
How much? 73% on the highway.
So you're 73%? Okay, so it's gone up.
We've got 16,384 left. And a lot of it's going on snow and ice.
So there's still 16,384 left.
Yeah, there's still
16,384. Which is what I had here. Yeah. And then we're adding into that the 6,600. Well, those are going to be separate line items, right? An article for the. For the combustible cabinet
and the ventilator.
The air purification.
And then by then they can get they'll have the
figure. It'll only be done once.
Exactly, so we don't have to keep going back again and buying another one every year.
But I really think that you got to figure out why all of a sudden.
They wanted 3,000 more.
No, it wasn't. It was like 15 grand.
Well, between the 12,000 for those two units.
Right, those two units. Why all of a sudden did we end up, why did they.
Well, they're gonna have to get three quotes to us.
I know that, but why all of a sudden, how were they storing gasoline before? And when they do the acetylene stuff, how much acetylene stuff do they do? And why did they all of a sudden need these two things? I'm not saying they don't need them. I'm just saying why all of a sudden.
I will ask the question.
That's all I'm saying.
Well, I think the, well, I don't want to speculate, so I'm not going to say anything. All I can say is what they said at the meeting, which was they're not in compliance now.
Right.
And in order to be in compliance,
they need to explode
with their storage of flammables and with their welding, they would need to purchase the safety equipment.
Okay.
I just don't know why it wasn't done in the past.
That's all I'm asking.
Well, I mean, just
have they been able to, you know?
How much welding do they do?
Right.
See, I'm more concerned about the welding than the thing because I can understand having cans out and flammables. Right. You really should have them in an explosion-proof locker. But I go back to, well, how much welding are they doing? You know.
Well, there again, there's probably a difference. If you come up to a certain amount of stuff, you might have to have this cabinet. But if you only got one tank, you still have to have it? That's my question.
Did you hear that question?
What's that?
For that ventilation, the welding ventilation, what are the requirements? At what level of usage are you required to have ventilation?
Okay.
How much welding do you have to do before they say?
I would say that the answer probably is any.
Yeah.
I don't know.
In a confined space.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the explosion-proof cabinet is probably could be just.
That's good for everybody.
Well, I think if you're running around with 5 gallon or 10 gallon cans of gas that you use for the lawn mowers and some of the stuff like that.
You're not going to use them in the winter lawnmower, right?
Well, whenever you're walking around with five gallon cans of gas for whatever you got, whether mm-hmm. it be for a saw or anything else like mm-hmm. that, theoretically, my understanding is those things at night should be in the locker.
Yep.
In case, because you could end up fireproof cabinet.
Well, then here comes another state law, because how many homeowners? I'm just saying, you know, how many homeowners have the identical situation?
But in a highway, barn,
you got heavy equipment.
Heavy
equipment. You got heavy equipment and goes right through that can.
Right. Come up
to SPRAC.
Or you have standing tanks.
How much can you legally store?
And you got standing tanks of acetylene that are chained to the wall, and you got that. You could end up with a fire that'll blow the damn building.
Oh yeah, I'm not saying.
Well, if they come in with the backhoe and their bucket hits it when they're trying to fix it, or no one's paying attention, which they maybe got distracted.
Yeah.
Not paying attention, but they get distracted and someone backs into those.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're done with it, they put in the cabinet and that's it. And
so I didn't think of all those different scenarios because.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not the acetylene, it's the oxygen.
That too. Oh yeah. We don't want to have a hole down in the building, then we're going to have to fix it.
The highway barn will be in East Brookfield.
Right. Yeah.
That'll be sharing with another community so we could start a consortium.
Let's discuss the private roads, right? It's on this budget. The dollar for the private roads.
Oh, we decided.
What line?
Yeah.
Where did I see it? I just.
Let's see it.
Private road plowing? Is that under snow and ice?
Yep.
Is it on here?
No, it was an article that they were recommending.
No, we don't want to do that.
But it's usually a line in there. No, do we always do that?
145.
Okay.
Top of the page, second page. Right?
Yeah. It's on 144.
We usually have to, it's just
right.
A...
You're right. It's 144. It slides to the next page. I apologize.
It's, that's
starts
something...
Highway.
There it is, yeah.
We usually just put a dollar in there just for...
Keep it open.
It's a matter of semantics to keep the line open.
Well, if you don't do that, the state, then we're illegal by the state.
No, but see, he's trying to add up to 15,000.
Yeah.
But
that's what he's trying
to do. Trying to add 15,000, but it's already in the budget.
We've already been plowing these roads all along.
We're what, 40 miles of road in this town?
Right. 47?
40 miles.
Is it 40?
They've been talking 40.
Okay.
Yeah.
How many of them are private?
Did he say seven?
And some of them don't even get done because they're not meeting the requirements to get done. The paperwork you have to file, whatever you have to do.
Safe for their equipment and everything.
Although there are other towns that will, if it's a dirt road, that will grade it for the resident.
Is there a reason we're even having this discussion?
Yes.
You brought it up.
I brought it up because it's not in the budget. If we don't have a dollar in this budget, you cannot legally plow the roads. And this
I move that we include a dollar for the 18.
And the other reason I brought up, Bill, is because one of the selectmen want to bring it up at the annual town meeting not to plow private roads anymore.
That's baloney.
That's why.
I'll second that, Bill. Okay?
Okay. So.
Good.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Putting a dollar on that line. You okay with that, Tony?
Who seconded it?
I think we threw the whole budget out of that dollar. But.
I know.
So now we want to add this up? We
forget snow and ice throwing the budget off.
Yeah, right. Get the total?
Snow and ice at 316, he was over 51,449. And he's used more since.
Okay, so.
March 16th?
That's as of March 16th.
Yeah.
He is over.
Right.
How much?
51,449.96.
Yeah, we just had 2 days worth this past
96.
Weekend.
96.
So what do you think about us adding this all up, and then if we have to come back and add in something for the shoes or something, we can do that. At least we'll get this under control. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
You good with that, Marie?
So what are you talking about, approving it?
Yeah.
Or then you have to amend it?
Yeah, we'll just come back then and say, okay, we got to add $500 or $1,000 to it. We can do it. At least we'll get this under, get this one out of the way.
Do you have all the figures?
Yeah.
You get everything all added up?
No.
Can we go with a clean sheet for one of these, and then we can include them all? How's that? Does anyone have a clean sheet? Mine's a mess.
A clean set?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what they're...
He needs another copy. You've got a blank? Or the one that hasn't been... What's this one?
Is that the old one, or that's the new one? I just drew a bunch of... Oh, this is a clean one, Bill.
Okay.
Right. Let me write another one off.
Yes, copy it.
Yeah,
in case
so, we, yeah.
You won't have a clean one.
I just threw the old ones away so I wasn't going to get confused. And I get confused easy.
No.
I'm coming up with $310,924.
Where you
get that dollar?
I got the dollar in there, here. Keep me honest, $310,924.
Wait, it's on my dashboard here.
What's on your dashboard?
Okay, give that to William down here, please. Bob, you want to run the numbers off? Make sure we got each one.
You got 310.
I got 310,924. Okay, someone run the
let's
numbers.
Let's go line by line and make sure that we have the numbers.
That's what I
did. 54,368.
Is line 136.
Right. Check.
Check.
80,371.20.
Line 137. Check.
$5,248.
Line 138. Good.
13,520.
Got it?
Yep.
17,536.
Yep.
Got it.
17,050.
Got it?
Yep.
60,600.
Got it.
$930.
Got it.
A dollar.
Yep.
$1,600.
Got it.
$75,000.
$310,924.20, right? That's what you had. What do we have? $310,924.20.
If you want to put the 20 cents in.
Yeah.
0.20 cents?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you want to put that in.
You
got to
put the 20 cents, and that's one-fifth of the
private
road budget.
Oh,
it's in line 127,
goes to
20
cents.
I don't know if we
should do that. This is
going to
cause a lot of
headache.
I
think
take the 20 cents out.
No, yeah. What's it for? What line is that?
Take the 20 cents out.
Highway operator wages.
137, highway operator wages.
Oh, no, you better put that in.
I'd leave that alone.
I had nothing to do with it. Didn't I ever?
That's for the vernal equinox. You know,
that's
for the
summer. Right, so I'll back the 75 out then. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, it's snow. You can't put the 75 in it.
You can't.
All right,
put it
I stand
in?
Corrected. Hold on a second.
That's a separate item.
Okay.
Let me do
$235,924.20.
All right, 235,924.
235?
Right.
924.
20
cents.
Okay.
And 20 cents.
Say that again?
Oh, yeah.
No 20 cents.
235,924.
That's what I got.
235924?
You're correct.
Okay. And Snow and Ice is going to stay separate on my
name. That's what Bobby just told me, separate.
Are we putting the 20 cents in?
No.
We're still voting at that $75,000.
Yes.
Well, we're going to make two separate votes.
Yeah. Snow and Ice is its own, and that's line 153. Yes, level funded at 75,000.
Correct. That's your cherry sheet thing.
Yeah.
153.
So someone would entertain a motion for the highway only, 235,924.
Snow and Ice only.
No, we're gonna vote the highway first.
Total highway, and then
Snow and
Ice.
Then we're gonna do the Snow and Ice after, okay?
I'll make the motion for 935,924.
Second.
No.
235,924 for the total.
You just got finished saying that.
You said 935.
I'm sorry. 235,924.
That builds water again.
Who wants to second that?
I did.
And that's for the highway budget only.
Yeah.
Okay. Now,
all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And I'll make another motion to do Snow and Ice to remain at 75,000.
Thank you, Bob. Okay.
Okay.
Who seconds it?
I'll second it. Okay.
All in favor on that one?
Yeah.
Aye.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, just so you know, you got 6 minutes tonight.
There he goes. All right. Looking at his watch.
I think we did good. It took a little while, but
he's
going to
turn into a bloody pumpkin over there.
A Bilgewater Bob.
No, we have to. If we go beyond 9 o'clock, we have to go over.
Does anyone want the clean sheet?
I have two of them right here.
Updated numbers. Marie, do you need that?
Well,
that would be helpful.
You got a folder for everything? Did you put everything in?
Yeah, right in my file cabinet. Mother. Then I'm going to bring them over to Carrie.
Okay.
All right, Bob, did you get that? Maybe we can't, the printer? Did you bring that to the guy from North Brookfield?
I'm going to stay with the same guy that did last year.
This was last year.
Yeah. Do you guys still have the copies I ran off to you a couple meetings ago on the printers?
Oh.
Yeah.
Who's the guy going to do the warrant?
Well, we got to have three estimates, so we just want to take a quick vote tonight, and then we'll do the fire department Thursday. Mm-hmm. And I got the health department coming in a week from this Thursday. I talked to the police department.
Yeah.
I'm going to have him, he's going to come in, I'm sorry, the police is coming in a week from this Thursday. I'm trying to get the health department to come in this Thursday.
That's Mike, right? The health department?
Yes, both are Mikes. The police is still...
You got two.
What? By the way, just so you know, we're having these meetings Monday and Thursday nights.
Can you
meet
both days, Tony?
To the end of the month.
Do my best to get both days for all of the mess. I run the Boy Scout, I chair the Boy Scout Council in town, so we have to meet on Thursdays as well. But
this time of year is just bad because it's...
Sure. Well, once the town meeting goes, then we meet once a month.
I've got two bids here.
Just a cake.
For the printing?
Yes.
Oh, you got them?
Yeah.
I'll just print a bunch up.
I've got them.
Bob, you got some?
No. And what's the difference in the price?
Well, that doesn't include the guy from North Brookfield, right, Dave?
No, I got that right here. I'm making passes around.
All right, that I didn't see. Well, there were some differences. I was looking at the unit price per page, and what they were looking at, because it's less than half.
Which
one? For the Worcester, for Alpha Graphics, is $809.43 for the 500 books. It's $1,093 for Athol Press.
The same ones you have? Yeah.
Yes.
And then last year we used one from North Brookfield.
Yeah. And did they provide a quote? Did they provide a quote, the North Brookfield firm?
Yes, I'm trying to find out where.
I wonder why the difference.
Well, the weight of the paper is different. No? Yep. 50 pound.
And the other one is 20, right? I'm reading it right?
Yep. I'm not understanding why we need 50 pound paper.
Well, the other one is number...
It's 20.
Okay, 20.
This is last year's quote, and he told me he was going to keep it pretty close for us.
Okay.
But I couldn't get a quote from him right away.
Is the one from North Brookfield?
This one is from last year.
Yeah.
Tony, that's it. Marie, you want one of these?
Yep, I'm going to keep my collection.
Yeah, I think these two are in the competitive range, in my opinion.
Are these all related to one? This one thing?
So 350 copies. This is
oh, I got copies.
Yeah.
T-point.
This is for.
What do you got? Four bids? You got one from.
Well, I gave you the whole. Yeah, from last year. I just ran them all off.
Okay. For 325.
Oh, so this one's 500. Okay.
Yeah, the packet I just gave you has all this from last year. Less. Has them all.
All right,
yeah.
The guy that's going to keep us the same for. Last year was what, a select?
Select out of North Brookfield. And he's okay. Very, very accommodating too. Yeah.
We had him at 14 too.
Yeah.
You're talking basically a $100 difference between each of the bids.
That's correct.
You're talking 150 copy difference. So these are 500, 500, this is 350.
Oh, that's true.
Yep.
Yeah, but do good, we ever good. Use 500? How do
well,
we?
Well, that's another, what do you want to print? I think we should print.
Last year did we do 350?
I think that was kind of high.
Because if we used
oh, we're going to mail these out too. We're going to decide that.
Mm-hmm. We didn't last year.
I'd like to see them mailed out.
We did.
But we have to have time to mail them out.
Right.
And that means everybody's got to do their thing in town. Articles, everybody's got to be on board and got to be, this thing has to be all done.
I'm not seeing that as being realistic.
Well, I'm pushing, so. I think if
or if you don't mail, maybe you can make copies available to the police.
No, you do. They've done that.
We do. We leave them at the library. Post office,
yeah. Library.
350 is more than enough if we do not mail them.
Okay.
We have, what did we have at the town meeting last year? Anybody know? Sharon, you remember how many we had last year? It was maybe 120.
How many were left over? More importantly, how much was left over after everything was over?
I don't want to say. It was a lot.
So then don't do any more than whatever.
Well, if we're getting 500 books at $809 on Alpha Graphics and 350 books for $978 from the guy in North Brookfield.
He's higher.
A lot.
Yeah. Yep.
Let's just do 978 divided by 350.
So you're looking at $2.19 a copy from Athol Press.
What is it again?
$2.19 a copy at 500 copies at $1,093.59.
All right.
You're getting $2.79 a copy at 350 copies at $7,978 from North Brookfield.
That's 70, 60 cents. That's a lot.
That's 60 cents more.
Yeah.
And then you're looking at $1.62 a copy, which is
Alpha.
A lot less from Alpha for 350 copies. No, that's for 500 books as well.
Yeah.
162?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think another one of the things though that we took into consideration one time was because he is a local merchant and we were trying to help out.
Because we went up the day before they had
run to him at the last minute and
that's
bam,
the reason
he's got it done.
Yeah.
You know?
Well,
and another thing, the more copies you make, it brings the price down.
Sure. And if they can give us the same price for 350 copies as they can for 500 copies.
Right.
And personally, I think you should work on the assumption, as Bill has suggested, you're not going to get this on time. It's probably going to be the last minute. And you shouldn't do 350 copies.
If we're not going to mail them. Right. And if we keep them in-house, then maybe we should do 300, maybe?
Well, find out what the best price is, what the minimum is to get the best price.
Yeah.
All right, here's your question. If they go out by mail, do you get better attendance at the meeting?
No,
it means nothing.
Then why mail? We go through the expense of mailing them out.
And another question. If the difference between top and bottom is 162 and 279, is it worth it to spend the extra $1.17 a copy when most people are going to, after they use it, it's going to end up, right, exactly, it's going to end up in the trash anyway. You know,
right.
Some people will save them and, you know, I like to look to that kind of stuff or whatever, but eventually I'm going to toss it too. But I mean, most of them are going to end up in the trash at the end of the day.
But so. See, what I like to do is get a mail so people can actually analyze them at their house. Because when you come to the meeting, everybody's talking in your ear, everybody's running around, you don't have time to really see, you know, hey, vote for this is good, vote for that, you know? Okay,
it's no time to think about it.
Oh, it's nice to be able to come to the meeting and say,
I know what I'm
have your questions in order too.
Right, exactly. I'm going to know what I know what this is all about because I looked at the pros and cons in the book.
Well, if we order 500 copies, it's less expensive than getting 350 copies for the other vendor. So
now this vendor, although he's out of Connecticut and it's from 2016, he did 500 copies for an estimate and 20-pound paper, $325.
Now, I don't know how long it takes.
But I know we were talking about, you had mentioned like looking at Tantasco for that roof over there.
Right.
Now, then to the printing. Baypath has a printing department. I don't know if Tantasco does. Tantasco does, great. If not,
right.
Baypath definitely has a printing department.
That's
and you could, we could probably save a lot of money by having them done there.
I wouldn't recommend that just because it's a school and we're so close to the line and
time
goes
correct,
wrong.
Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah, I don't know how long it would turn around would be for them, but
right.
If you know.
Right.
I mean, if we gave this a month ahead, I'd say let's go for it.
Sure.
But we'll always wait till
talking just the warrant.
Makes sense.
You know what I mean? I just can't take that chance and then.
No. I didn't think about that factor. You're right.
How much is it cost for postage?
We paid a lot. 2 years later.
I forget now. They do a bulk rate.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Have you thought about posting the warrant online so people can download it? That'll save your postage and they can get it quicker.
Okay. If we get it on,
put it on the town website. The minute
okay,
you get it
I like that. If we get it, if we get it done a few days ahead, we can do that, right?
Yeah.
And
we
then
just put the proof on there. Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
You could also probably put it in Facebook in the Brookfield Facebook
for
page.
For how many cars?
Yeah, we could do that.
It doesn't say how
I've been going there. I've been getting a lot of information out of that one. I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
Did a nice job with that Facebook
page. It doesn't
say
how many copies, Bobby.
Okay. And then we can decide how many we want printed off.
Yeah,
I don't think we need
350
if it's going to be in house.
Well, you have a number of people who are not into internet access either, so you got to have coverage for that.
Well, I'll ask the town clerk how many
people
showed up at the meeting.
Huh? Most of the people in your neighborhood, right?
I would think so. I don't know.
Did we make a motion to go past 9?
No respect.
No, we didn't.
They leave me alone.
Someone make a motion to go past 9?
I told them to go up. They leave me alone.
Just a few minutes. Just
begrudging.
Just wanted to go through the proper procedure.
All right.
So.
Move that we extend our meeting past 9 p.m.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
No discussion will be available.
No,
Bill.
No.
No discussion?
None.
Okay, so. Want me to actually get a firm?
Yes.
From North Brookfield tomorrow, next for Harvard for Thursday meeting.
Yeah.
Then we can decide.
Yeah. I mean, if it's lowest bid,
even if he's
I
a
think
little
it
more,
is.
And it's and he's good because he's saved us a few times.
A little more is
little
one
more,
thing,
but like,
this is
right,
the, you
right.
Got to work with us just a little bit.
Well, the other thing that Bobby brought up is he's got a copy from 2014. From this particular vendor, and the one that's $953.
Yeah.
And in 2013, 2014 for the town warrant, it was $560.
Wow, big difference.
So.
How many copies was it? Same.
I'm looking. The page underneath it says 400. I'm thinking this goes. You know, this says thank you for your opportunity to bid. I'm guessing this is the details, and that was 400. Copies then number 20 stock.
So they're all going to be the same, all vendors.
Yeah. Well, so that was kind of surprising.
This one's 350, so it's 50 bucks.
Almost double the price.
Okay, what else we got to do, boss?
All right. You're going to
make
it.
Someone can make a motion to adjourn.
What are you doing with these now?
I'm going to call Select out of North Brookfield and get a firm quote from him based on what he did. You want me to get a quote on?
Let me see something. Is that
300?
That's not him. Where's the
275? Right here.
Well, see what the prices are as you go up the number of copies. What is the? I'm sure they have like categories up to 150.
Because it gets cheaper the more you print.
150 to 200.
Yeah,
exactly. So
if we're gonna go social media and things like that, we could save quite a bit of stuff. You're not gonna have to all those books.
Yeah, if you got 300 copies, that's more than enough.
Well, if he had 160 left over from last year.
Just give you something.
How are you going to let everybody know it's on social media?
Well, let people. Well, we can put that up there too. To be
you can put it in the Citizen.
He will put it on his sign on Route 9.
No. He can't do that.
He's a private citizen. As a thing, he can say.
You can get the warrant online.
Let's not go there.
That would be
how many pages? That's another. How many pages do you think we're going to need?
Well, it's usually 32 pages, isn't it? From what I've seen.
Well, count it then.
32 pages in these quotes.
Yeah.
They all say 32 pages for the quotes.
just so I can tell them something. I can't.
Are you having you on board, baby?
Oh, it's gonna be about.
Yeah, give us a price per page on 20 pound, and then a 50 pound cover, saddle stitch.
20 pound. Yeah.
Some of those savings. Okay. Yeah, once.
Yeah.
We definitely don't need 50 pound paper.
For the cover only.
Oh, yeah.
20 pound for the body, 50 pound for the cover, saddle stitch.
How many pages are in there? Saddle stitch?
They were not numbered.
I don't know the terminology.
They weren't numbered, just right.
What is saddle stitch, those?
Right, staples in the middle.
Okay.
They're told just one staple?
There should be three or two.
Oh, okay. That's what they call saddle stitch?
I've got one actually. It's a big, it's a stapler about this long.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Bill, you gonna be here Thursday? I want you to be here when we do the trees. That's why I'm asking you.
Oh, I'll be here for that.
Oh, well, you gonna be here Thursday?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Did I give? We got copies. I think we already got the copies.
We're doing the trees on Thursday?
Yeah. If I can find them in the file cabinet, I think I know.
What do you want?
We gotta do the shade trees.
I'll be here on Thursday.
15, 16.
Okay, Steve should be here too, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Tony, so you're gonna try 20? To get sworn at between now and Thursday if you can, so you can vote.
Okay. Yep. I'll
21.
Mike around tomorrow.
20 pages. That means.
Is Mike around tomorrow there right now?
Yeah,
probably. Mike's up there.
You need to get tomorrow.
And Wednesday he stays to 8 o'clock.
I'm gonna see.
Oh yeah, no problem.
Wednesday night.
41.
41 pages.
Oh, you could have cut. You can catch him at the dump tomorrow.
And then the cover.
Yeah, possibly.
41 plus cover. You can show him.
Somebody want to make a motion to adjourn?
Are you going up there?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Yeah, I know.
Second?
It's crazy.
Next meeting is the tree people. Where's it going to be?
The tree people.
Tree people, huh?
Shade tree, yeah.
Shade tree. Anybody else?
And then we're going to do a recap on the
fire.
Have you forgot the treasurer's budget?
I don't know if she's back yet. She had back problems.
And you're going to recap?
Fire
department.
EMS, too.
And EMS, yeah.
All right, that's it?
Unless I can get the health department in Thursday, then we'll just skip that. We'll put health possible.
I'll put it just to keep, yeah.
And you can also put online new business, old business, if you want to put,
Yeah,
usually
I would.
You do?
I put that on there. Okay, now you can make a motion to adjourn.
Someone want to entertain a motion to adjourn?
Make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor. No discussion. I won't entertain any discussion.